Craft introduced their 3.0 edition this week, and today we're going to overview everything you need to know about the task collections that are like Notion databases and styling that come with Craft 3. We're going to overview it all in this video. So before we begin today's video, thank you very much to Sun Sama for sponsoring this video. If you're interested in a daily planner app that combines tasks, calendar, and tasks from other applications, then it's worth checking out the trial for Sun Sama below. They've got a powerful application that's going to help you to plan your week with a focus on work-life balance and to reduce burnout. You can check out all the powerful features in Sun Sama below. So, Craft introduced over 100 new updates, and some of them were very small, and we're going to overview the major ones in this video. And this is probably the biggest Craft update I've seen in my lifetime, and the application has really evolved over the last couple of years. And I think I want to start with some of the basic stuffs, like where it's available on and the pricing and details like that. So first and foremost, this application is expanded to Windows, Web, Mac, and iOS, and it comes as a core experience for those applications, not just focusing on documents and notes anymore, but also allowing you to do more. Now, one of these big updates comes for task management, but before we begin with that, the pricing has changed quite dramatically. The pricing is now got a free tier with 10 documents free and 2 that you can add every single week. But there is a premium tier pricing, which starts at $8 per user per month, with some of the discounts still running from the Cyber Monday / V3 launch. So now that we've got that out of the way, I think it's best to start with the task management. Now, Craft have been hinting at task management for a very long time. They've had reminder abilities more recently added, allowing you to set reminders on items that you need to do. But task management has now got its own tab inside the experience, which not just allows you to see your active tasks, but documents that have tasks within them and the progress that they have been completed so far, turning any of your documents into a potential project in themselves, allowing you to indicate how much you need to get done, as well as managing tasks separately and universally is part of an area inside of Craft. Now, many people are welcoming this update and the actual ability to have all of these functions with priority, due dates, and the management of the task being completed is huge inside of Craft. Now, you can also combine this with your daily notes, allowing you to see your calendar and your tasks in consolidation, which is a really helpful experience. And there's loads of ways that you could customize this even further too. There's even a dedicated task inbox as well, and the iOS reminders function works incredibly well for capturing tasks on the go quickly. Next up is this Notion-like collections ability. Now, collections is something that Craft has introduced, and now whilst it won't replace the likes of Notion entirely, it does allow you to create a database, organize that with filters and sorting, and group them based on things that matter to you most. It's really easy to use and works incredibly well on mobile, but most importantly, it does build the infrastructure to potentially adding more views in the future. Right now, you're only able to get table view, but it's a great way to start tallying things and using attributes that are important to you. They're also planning a relation ability in the future, which is currently in beta, which allows you to connect each collections together, which could be incredibly helpful for building a network of the collections that you have inside of your account. And what I must say is they look really nice with the new styling. So that's a great segue. Styling has always been important inside of Craft. Well, in this update, they go a step further. And what they do is allow styling to be even better. You previously were able to make and customize the page cards inside of your account, which you can still do, but you can now customize the page in much more detail. You can add wasabi tape, you can add colors to the background, you change the font and the entire feel of it, including doing all of the regular stuff like page breaks and more. Here's an example of how I use some of the templates to quickly turn something into a really basic looking document into a really clean and cool looking document that I could share externally with other people. And that's really the power of Craft 3, is that you have this new template gallery that's going to take the customization level of your pages and notes into the stratosphere. And it's really cool what you can do with this. Some people were saying in the comments that you could use this all the way from a kid's birthday party all the way to a professional document and still find a gap in the middle for whatever you're working on. So it really gives you that control and that customization that makes you feel like you've designed it around your liking. This extends to the mobile application, which has a new interface for customizing and styling as well on mobile, which is an incredible feat of engineering. Bearing in mind the previous iOS version of Craft was already good, and now it's a lot better. So many people do ask, Francesco, is Craft right for me? Is it a replacement for Notion? And my short answer is, Notion is much more powerful and functional than Craft is at the current time. But it does have some great abilities if you're looking to move away from an entirely database run and structured layout. The application primarily focuses on documents and that customization around documents. And it's got much more of a focus on that structural productivity like calendar and task management that you don't necessarily get inside of Notion, where you have to build a lot of the accounts and you have to get set up. Although obviously you do have Notion Home more recently. This is much more customizable as well with the more recent updates and goes much more beyond the customizable abilities with page layouts and things like that. It turns into expression of creativity versus necessarily a structure of your layouts, if that makes sense. So one of the things that I've actually been doing is been using Craft for the last sort of 6 months to play around with a lot of stuff. And I'm feeling more and more and moving over to Craft from Notion, because I feel like it's much more functional and easy to use, especially on the go and offline. And this has definitely been something that's gradually going towards. So I will look forward to testing all of these new features out in full capacity. So folks, what do you think about Craft? Please do let me know in the comments below. If you do love Craft, I would love for you to review Craft over on Toolfinder. You can find the link in the description to go over and check it out. Leave a review, share your love or your feedback in general. We'd love to hear what you think of the application. Thank you very much, folks, and I look forward to seeing you in a future video, and I'll hopefully help you find the best productivity tool out there. So cheerio for now.